John's workshop tells the story of 16 years spent designing, building, and battling robots. Robot fighting is serious business, with its own governing body and strict rules and regulations. Within the arena, competition is fierce, and reputations can be ruined in a matter of seconds.
You have this big adrenaline rush, and then as soon as the lights come on and you start your fight, adrenaline and nerves, it's all gone, and all of a sudden you're just in the zone, focused on your fight. So you've got different weapons that you can use, things like axes, flippers, spinning discs, flamethrowers, you name it, you can do it. You just got to basically take out all your aggression, but you use a robot to do it. So before we had two blades and they were horizontal, they weren't angled at all. So what I'm thinking about doing is putting them on slightly different. Now this is an old one. This was the one that was on before. Now this fitted on here. It was just flat, and that's the idea. This bit comes around and hits the other robots. But what I'm gonna do is I've made a prototype piece of steel. This time, I'm actually gonna angle them. So the idea is it's gonna get underneath the robots and actually do more damage. We also only had two before. So three is bigger than two, so I think I'm going to put three blades on as well, and hopefully then we'll have three times the destruction. So this is what we're going to do now, we've got to make the blades.
Cyclone 360 won't be facing another robot for some months. In the meantime, John plans to test its powers against some less mobile opponents. Waiting in the wings, an old PC, an oven, and a washing machine. If Cyclone can put pay to them, he may have a future in robot fighting.
So basically you've got a mixture of a plasma, so you're burning the metal, but you've also got compressed air, which is blowing it through as well. So that's how you end up with a nice clear cut. And that's it, we've got our first blade already cut out. Let's move this out of the way.
John's fashioning three solid steel cutting blades to attach to Cyclone 360's outer casing. Once the robot gets up to full speed, these blades should be capable of inflicting some serious damage.
The beauty of this with the CNC plasma cutter is that they're all going to be exactly the same as well. One of the things that's important with this robot is the balance. So each of the blades needs to be put in the right place. They all need to be the same weight, because if you don't do that, what'll happen is it'll wobble and it's going to fall over and go all over the place. So we need to make sure that these are the same weight.
An old lorry wheel is about to be transformed into a mechanical killing machine, complete with angled blades to upend and obliterate any opponent. John has his own custom-built test arena, complete with polycarbonate walls to protect spectators from any flying metal. Welding complete, it's time for Cyclone 360 to take its first tentative steps back into the world of ultimate fighting robots.
So we've got our battle arena behind me here. Hopefully, these teeth are going to be destructive. There's going to be bits flying all over the place. So we're going to get the robot in, then we'll get our first test piece in there, and let's create some destruction.
First up, an old PC tower, complete with drive interface, three USB ports, and fully installed antivirus software.
Served me well, this PC, until the end, but I don't think this will be any match for the destructive capabilities of Cyclone 360.
Remote control at the ready. It's time to see whether John's new design will do the job.
I'm going to get it spinning up, and then we'll wait for the big bang, see what happens. So we're going to get it lined up, and start it spinning. To give it another hit. Maybe go for one more. Bit more speed. I think that PC's pretty dead.
It's round one to Cyclone 360, and it hasn't sustained a single scratch.
Okay, so there's bits everywhere. We'd hit it three times. Yeah, I don't think this PC is going to work anymore. It's completely destroyed it. But the new blade seems to be working pretty well. So, time for the oven.
Next up, a multifunctional integrated kitchen oven with enamel interior and fully programmable timer.
Well, that was a nice impact. Oh, yes. No more cooking for that oven. Let's go and have a look. OK, yeah, there's bits everywhere again in the arena. Oh, what a mess, what a mess. OK, yeah, so we've hit it at the front. You can see the thickness of this. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4 layers of steel in there. There's not much left. The door, I don't even know where the door is. It's in pieces all over the place. Just check the robot over. Yeah, robot's tip-top condition. It's no match for the robot. Nice
healthy. Cyclone 360 takes the second round. But the final and toughest test is about to begin. How will Cyclone's spin-powered skills fare against the spin cycle of John's washing machine?
So there's concrete in the bottom of this, so it's going to be a heavy impact. Again, thick steel, bits of plastic. I don't know, maybe the door's going to come off, but let's get it in the arena. Let's see how it fares. Oh, this is heavy. That's the bad boy. I bet this weighs more than the robot itself.
The final opponent, a fully automatic washing machine with 3 spin cycles, optional eco setting, and variable temperature.
Right, okay, here we go then.
First, a tickle. Then a full-blooded attack. John's new blades have put pay to the opponent in seconds.
I think that's the end of the washing machine. Robot 1, washing machine 0. Right, let's go have a look. The door's hanging off. We've got bits hanging out. You can see where the blades have actually cut all the way through the steel. That's what we want to do when we're fighting other robots. And obviously the insides here. Yeah, there's not much left. We'll just check the robot, make sure it's all fine. Pretty sure it is. It's made of tough stuff. The blades, we scratched the paint a little bit. Yeah, I think we're ready for battle now.
The test has been a complete success, but washing machines don't fight back. In the coming months, Cyclone 360 will be tested against ever tougher opponents. John's hope is that eventually it'll take to the arena once more to wreak revenge on its rival.